पार्स अवर्स आइडेंटिटी। पार्सवल्स आइडेंटिटी। माइनस इनफिनिटी प्लस इनफिनिटी मॉडल्स ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स होल स्क्वायर डी एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस इनफिनिटी प्लस इनफिनिटी जी ओमेगा होल स्क्वायर डी ओमेगा is the modulus identity for the complex form of Fourier transform. For Fourier cosine transform 0 to infinity fc of x f of x g of x equal to 0 to infinity fc omega gc omega d omega is the Fourier. This is the multiple functions. This is multiple of Fourier transforms, respect to Fourier transforms. Again, 0 to infinity f of x whole square dx. If g of x, f of x are same, then 0 to infinity gc omega d omega square. Again, 0 to infinity f of x g of x dx sine transform 0 to infinity f s of omega g s of omega d omega 0 to infinity f of x whole square dx. The both functions are same, then sine transform 0 to infinity g of s omega whole square d omega. This is complex form of Fourier transform. Parsons identity for complex form of Fourier transform. These Fourier cosine transform, different functions of x. The same function of x, Fourier cosine transform. The different functions of x and product, different function of different Fourier transform, Fourier sine transforms. This only function, the four two sums are same, therefore g omega whole square. These are the Fourier transform. We are going to see some sums in the complex form of Fourier transform. Find the Fourier transform of f of x equal to 1 when modulus of x less than 1 equal to 0 modulus of x greater than 1, and hence deduce that zero to infinity sine square t by t square dt equal to pi by 2. We have to use Parsons identity. Already I have given in the initial class. You know the formula. f of x equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus infinity plus infinity g omega e power I omega x d omega. G omega equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus into plus infinity f of x e power minus I omega x dx. The meaning of this is minus 1 to 1. Its meaning is remaining areas 1 to infinity, minus infinity to minus 1. We are splitting this integral into three steps, three parts. 1 by root of 2 pi bracket minus infinity to minus 1 f of x e power minus I omega x dx plus minus 1 to 1 f of x e power minus I omega x dx plus 1 to infinity f of x e power minus I omega x dx. See, this denotes the remaining areas minus infinity to minus 1, 1 to infinity. In these two areas, f of x is 0. This denotes minus 1 to 1. In this minus 1 to 1, f of x is 1. Minus 1 to 1, f of x is 1. We are applying this function f of x in this equal to 1 by root of 2 pi. Here f of x is 0 plus minus 1 to 1, f of x is 1 here, e power minus I omega x dx plus 0, the remaining area, this is 0, equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus 1 to 1, e power minus I omega x dx. Equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus 1 to 1 cos omega x minus I sin omega x dx. We are splitting into 2. 1 by root of 2 pi minus 1 to 1 cos omega x dx minus I by root of 2 pi minus 1 to 1 sin omega x dx. This is odd function. Sin won't give negative. Sin minus theta is, sin will give negative. Sin minus theta is minus sin theta. Cos won't give negative. Cos minus theta is cos theta. Therefore, negative won't come out. Therefore, this is even function. This is odd function. Imaginary part always 0. Imaginary part always will be odd function, will become 0. Equal to twice of root of 2 pi 0 to 1 cos omega x dx minus 0. Integrating 2 by root of 2 pi sin omega x by omega, limit is 0 to 1, equal to 2 by root of 2 pi sin omega by omega sin 0 by omega. Sin 0 is 0. 2 by root of 2 pi g omega equal to sin omega by omega is the Fourier transform. G omega equal to 2 by root of 2 pi sin omega by omega. Parseval's identity. Yeah.
heredity.
Minus into plus infinity, f of x whole square dx equal to minus into plus infinity, g omega whole square d omega. The sum is f of x equal to 1 when modulus of x less than 1, equal to 0, modulus of x greater than 1. Therefore, this is already we have done, minus only would come f of x 1 square dx, minus into plus infinity, 0 by is 2 by root of 2 pi sin omega by omega whole square d omega minus 1 to 1 dx equal to 4 by 2 pi whole square 4 by 2 pi minus plus infinity sin omega by omega whole square d omega. This is without function, always it will be even function. Therefore, twice of 0 to 1 dx equal to 2 by pi, this is even function, sine negative 1, negative 1, sine 1, negative would give, here also negative, positive, whole square is positive. Therefore, twice of 0 to infinity, even function, steps we have applied here, sine square omega by omega square d omega. Integrating 2x, integral of dx is x, 4 by pi 0 to infinity sin square omega by omega square d omega, limit is 0 to 1, upper limit is 1, lower limit is 0, equal to 4 by pi 0 to infinity sin square omega by omega square d omega. Two equal to 4 by pi 0 to infinity sin square omega by omega square d omega. 2 comes down, pi goes up. Therefore, pi by 2 equal to 0 to infinity sin square omega by omega square d omega, 0 to infinity sin square t by t square dt equal to pi by 2 by dummy changing. Hence the result. Again, sum number 2, find the Fourier transform of f of x equal to 1 modulus of x less than a equal to 0 modulus of x greater than a, and deduce that zero to infinity sin square t by t square dt equal to the same what the in the what we have seen the previous sum. We know f of x equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus and plus infinity g omega e power I omega x d omega. G omega equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus or plus infinity f of x e power minus I omega x dx. Meaning of this is minus a to a. Its meaning is remaining areas a to infinity minus b to minus a. We are splitting into this integral three parts. you could 1 by root of 2 pi minus infinity to minus 1 minus v to minus a f of x e power minus I omega x dx plus minus a to a f of x e power minus I omega x dx plus a to infinity f of x e power minus I omega x dx. These two become zero outer areas. Minus a to only in the limit f of x is 1. Equal to 1 by root of 2 pi minus, this is 0, minus 8 f of x is 1, e power minus I omega x dx plus 0. 1 by root of 2 pi minus 8 a e power minus I omega x dx. 1 by root of 2 pi minus 8 a cos omega x minus I sin omega x dx. One by root of 2 pi minus ATA cos omega x dx minus I by root of 2 pi minus ATA sin omega x dx. We have split into two. This is imaginary part, sin omega x. It won't give negative, it will give negative outside. If it will be odd function 0, cos omega is even function. 1 by root of 2 pi twice of 0 to a cos omega x dx minus 0. 2 by root of 2 pi 0 to a cos omega x dx. Integrating 2 by root of 2 pi sin omega s by omega, limit is 0 to a. You got upper limit sin omega, putting into, we have integrated with respect to x only, therefore putting a for x, therefore a omega by omega minus sin x is 0 by omega. Sin 0 is 0, therefore g omega equal to 2 by root of 2 pi sin a omega by omega is the Fourier transform. Again, Parseval's identity. Minus to plus infinity f of x whole square dx equal to minus plus infinity g omega whole square d omega. Here f of x is 1 when modulus of x less than a equal to 0, modulus of x greater than a. Therefore minus a to a f of x is 1 square dx equal to minus infinity plus infinity g by I is 2 by root of 2 pi sin a omega by omega whole square d omega. Minus a to a dx. equal to 4 by 2 pi minus plus infinity sine a omega by omega whole square d omega. This no function here, 1 is there, therefore always even function, twice of 0 to a dx 2 by pi, this also even, sine will give negative outside, omega is negative, positive, whole square is positive, therefore twice of 0 to even function, completely even function, 0 to infinity sine square a omega by omega square d omega. Integration of dx is x 0 to a 4 by pi 0 to infinity sin square a omega by omega squared d omega. Upper limit is a, lower limit is 0, equal to 4 by pi infinity sin square a omega by omega squared d omega. 2a equal to 4 by pi 0 to infinity sin square d omega by omega square d omega. (2a/4π) coming this side equal to 0 to infinity sin square a omega by omega square d omega. (a/π/2) equal to 0 to infinity sin square a omega by omega square d omega. Here we are substituting. Put a omega equal to t, omega equal to t by a d omega equal to dt. Since omega and t are variables, therefore d omega equal to dt by a, limits unchangeable. When omega equal to infinity, t also infinity. When omega equal to 0, t also 0. Therefore, limits unchanged. Therefore, (a/π/2) equal to 0 to infinity sin square t, sin square t. What is omega? T by a. T by a whole square d omega dt by a. (a/π/2) 0 to infinity sin square t by t square a square, this a square comes up, dt by a, only a cancelled, a into 0 to infinity sin square t by t square dt, a get cancelled, (π/2) equal to 0 to infinity sin square t by t square dt, hence a result.